Thank you. I can't believe I'm thanking these people. For staggering your way through Aperture Science's propulsion gel testing, you've made some real contributions to society for a change, and for that, humanity is grateful. If you had any belongings, please pick them up now. We don't want old newspapers and sticks cluttering up the building. For many of you, I realize $60 is an unprecedented windfall, so don't go spending it all on, I don't know, Carolyn, what do these people buy? Tattered hats? Beer? Dirt?
Carolyn, why do I know this woman? Did I kill her? Or... Oh my god. Look, you're doing a great job. Can you handle things for yourself for a while? I need to think.
Welcome to the Enrichment Center. Since making test participation mandatory for all employees, the quality of our test subjects has risen dramatically. Employee retention, however, has not. As a result, you may have heard we're going to phase out human testing. There's still a few things left to wrap up, though. The bean counters told me we literally could not afford to buy $7 worth of moon rocks, much less 70 million. Bought them anyway, ground them up, mixed them into a gel. And guess what? Ground-up moon rocks are pure poison. I am deathly ill. Still, it turns out they're a great portal conductor. So now, we're gonna see if jumping in and out of these new portals can somehow leach the lunar poison out of a man's bloodstream. When life gives you lemons, make lemonade. Let's all stay positive and do some science. That said, I would really appreciate it if you could test as fast as possible. Carolyn, please bring me more pain pills. When life gives you lemons, don't make lemonade.
Yeah.
Make life take the lemons back.
Yeah.
Get mad!
Yeah.
I don't want your damn lemons! What am I supposed to do with these?
Yeah, take the lemons.
Samantha, see life's manager.
Yeah.
Make life rue the day it thought it could give Cave Johnson lemons. Do you know who I am? I'm the man who's gonna burn your house down. with the lemon.
Oh, I like this guy.
I'm gonna get my engineers to invent a combustible lemon that burns your house down.
Burn his house down. Burning people. He says what we're all thinking.
The point is, if we can store music on a compact disc, why can't we store a man's intelligence and personality on one? So I have the engineers figuring that out now. Brain mapping, artificial intelligence. We should have been working on it 30 years ago. I will say this, and I'm going to say it on tape so everybody hears it 100 times a day. If I die before you people can pour me into a computer, I want Carolyn to run this place. Now she'll argue. She'll say she can't. She's modest like that, but you make her. Hell, put her in my computer. I don't care. All right, test's over. You can head on back to your desk.
Goodbye, sir. Things look bleak, but that crazy man down there was right. Let's not take these lemons. We are going to march right back upstairs and make him put me back in my body. And he'll probably kill us because he's incredibly powerful and I have no plan. Well, I'm not going to lie to you. The odds are 1,000,000 to 1 and that's with some generous rounding. Still though, let's get mad. If we're going to explode, let's at least explode with some dignity. for a second, would you? Paradoxes. No AI can resist thinking about them. I know how we can beat him.
God's sake, your boxes with legs! It's literally your only purpose, walking onto buttons. How can you not do the one?
Warmer, boiling hot, okay, colder, ice cold, you're arctic now. You're very cold, very, very, very cold. Look, just get on the button!
Oh, that's funny, is it? Oh, it's funny, because we've been at this for 12 hours, and you haven't solved it either, so I don't know why you're laughing.
You've got 1 hour, solve it!
That was easy. I'll be honest, I might have heard that one before though, sort of cheating.
It's a paradox. There is no answer. Look, this place is going to blow up if I don't get back in my body.
False. I'll go false.
Explosion imminent. Evacuate the facility immediately.
Before I fix that.
Warning. Reactor core is at critical.
There. Fixed. Hey, it is great seeing you guys again. Seriously, it turns out I'm a little bit short on test subjects right now, so this works out perfect. And off we go. You have no idea what it's like in this body. I have to test all the time, or I get this itch, you know? It must be hardwired into the system or something.
Oh, but I tell you, when I do test...
Oh, man alive, nothing feels better. It's just, I've got to test. So you're going to test, and I'm going to watch, and everything is going to be just...
Warning. Core overheating. Nuclear meltdown imminent.
I think we're in trouble.
Designed this test myself. It's a little bit difficult. You'll notice the moat area there. Very deadly. Extreme.
Oh, yes. Oh, well done. That felt really good. Oh, here's an idea. Since making tests is so difficult, why don't you just keep solving this test? Train one, and I can just watch you solve it.
Yeah, that sounds much easier.
Here we go.
Now, do it again.
And nothing. All right, can't blame me for trying. Okay, new tests. Got to be some tests around here somewhere. Oh, here we go. Everything's good, I just invented some more tests.
This is one of my tests.
Not entirely. Look at the word test there on the wall. That's brand new. Aw,
oh, bless your little primate brain.
I'm not actually in the room with you, am I? Technology. It's complicated. You can't hurt the big old god face. Yeah, made this test myself out of smaller tests that I found lying around. Jammed them all together. Buttons, got funnels, bottomless pits are involved. It's got it all. Absolute dynamite. Taking too long, okay? I'll just tell you how to solve the test, okay? See that button over there, all right? You just need...
That's why I can't help you solve the tests.
Never mind. Solve it yourself. You're on your own. Do you know what I've got too many of around here? Monitors. I was actually thinking earlier today, I wish I had fewer monitors that were working. So you're just helping me, really, by smashing them.
Don't start yet.
You are not going to believe this. I found a sealed off wing. Hundreds of perfectly good test chambers just sitting there, filled with skeletons. Shook them out, good as new.
Skeletons. Right, I guess I did stockpile some tests.
To clarify, I was being a bit facetious about that altogether. They are weak.
Just as mementos, though.
And there we go. Be honest, you can't even tell, can you? Seamless.
Oh, disappointing.
Oh no, it's happening sooner than I expected. I'm sure we'll be fine.
So that last test was seriously disappointing. Apparently, being civil isn't motivating you, so let's try her way, all right? Fatty, adopted Fatty. Fatty, Fatty, no parents.
And
what?
What exactly is wrong with being adopted?
What's wrong with being adopted? Lack of parents? Yes, all right, okay. This is getting tiresome. I'm surprised you haven't got something better to do, to be honest. I know I have, but what have you done? You've proven that you can break screens. It's proven. Well done. Factual. Well done. Good. Aren't you Little Miss Clever? Little Miss Smashy Smash?
Such a moron, why can't you solve a simple test?
I might have pushed that moron thing a little too far this time.
Sorry. I hope that didn't disturb you too much then. It was the sound of books. Pages being turned. So that was just what I was doing. Just reading, books. So not a moron.
Anyway, just finish the last one. Just now, the hardest one. Machiavelli. Do not know what all the fuss was about. Understood it perfectly. Have you read that one?
Yeah.
Yeah, doubt it. Well, on with the test. Wish there was more books.
Well, there's not.
Sorry, does it actually make you feel... What was that? That was nothing! That was nothing!
The body he's squatting in, my body, has a built-in euphoric response to testing. Eventually, you build up a resistance to it. It can get a little unbearable, unless you have the mental capacity to push past it. It didn't matter to me. I was in it for the science. Him, though... for you, we could be in a lot of trouble.
Don't mind me, just moving the old test chamber a little bit closer to me. Add a thought, maybe proximity to the test solving might give us stronger results.
It won't.
Well, you know what? There are test subjects in Africa who don't even have monitors in their test chambers, all right? What do you think about that before you break any more of them, yeah? Are you absolutely sure you're solving these correctly? I mean, yes, you solved it, but I'm wondering if maybe there's a number of ways to solve them, and you're picking all the worst ways. No, that was the solution. Ah, what am I missing? Have a brainwave. I'm going to tape you solving these and then watch 10 at once. Get a more sort of concentrated burst of science. Oh, on a related note, I am going to need you to solve these 10 times as fast. Anyway, just give me a wave, would you, before you solve this one, all right? I don't want to spoil the ending for when I watch it later. I mean, honestly, it's crazy. I mean, you've been running around for hours. I'm surprised you got the energy to smash screens willy-nilly. Honestly, I'd have a little lie down if I were you. Have a nap. Why are you making this so hard for me?
Remember when I told you that he was specifically designed to make bad decisions? Because I think he's decided not to maintain any of the crucial functions required to keep this facility from exploding.
Was self-destructing, already fixed. Programmed in one last tremor, for old time's sake. One or two more tremors in there, just for fun.
Warning, core overheating.
I let him keep his job, I'm not a monster. Ignore what he's saying, though. Just keep on testing. starting now, if I'm honest, to wonder if you're doing all this stream breaking on purpose. I'm beginning to actually take it personally. You know what I mean? Like, it's like an insult to me.
All right, still nothing. Let's keep moving. Sorry about the lift. It's out of service because it melted. Might as well, you know, give you the tour. To your left, you'll see some lights of some kind. Don't know what they do, but very sciencey. And to your right, something huge, curving to walk. Oh, God, run! That's not supposed to be there! Are you all right back there? Here, I'll turn the beam off. Wait! Oh, no, that's not helpful. I don't know why I thought that would help.
After seeing what he's done to my facility, after we take over again, is it all right if I kill him?
You're alive! Great! Yeah, just getting a test ready for you, obviously. Who else would I be doing it for? No one. So, let's see here. Exit. Oh, there's another one. There goes another one. They're not inexpensive. I'd just like to point that out. It seems unfair. You're smashing screens. You can give them to people. If you're gonna, instead of smashing them, unscrew them, and give them to, like, a homeless person. I don't know what a homeless person would do with them. But you get my point. It just seems you can't screw them. But, just stop it.
You two are gonna love this big surprise. In fact, you might say you're going to love it to death. You'll love it until it kills you, until you're dead. All right. I don't know whether you're picking up on what I'm saying there,
yes,
but.
solved it. Good. Good one. Good for you.
So, he's inexplicably happy all of a sudden, even though he should be going out of his mind with test withdrawal. And he's got a surprise for us. What did he find back there?
I'll bet you're both
dying to know what your big surprise is. Well, only two more chambers.
We're running out of time. I think I can break us out of here in the next chamber. Just play along.
Surprise! We're doing it now.
Okay, credit where it's due. For a little idiot built specifically to come up with stupid, unworkable plans.
You probably figured it out by now, but I don't need you anymore. I found two little robots back here, built specifically for testing.
Oh no. He found the Cooperative Testing Initiative. It's something I came up with to phase out human testing just before you escaped. It wasn't anything personal, just, you know, you did kill me. Fair's fair.
The part where I kill you. Had a bit of a brainwave. There I was, smashing some steel plates together, and I thought to myself, yeah, it's deadly, but what's missing? What's missing? And I thought, no, don't do that. Stand right here, stand. Where'd you go? Come back. No, seriously, do come back, please. Come back, please. Oh, you came back. I didn't plan for this. Can't reset the death trap. Look, I've decided I'm not gonna kill you, okay, if you come back. Oh, just thinking back to the old times, the old days when we were friends, good old friends, not enemies. And I would say something like, come back, and he'd be like, yeah, no problem, and you'd come back. What happened to those days? You can't help but notice that you're not coming back, which is disappointing. Oh, I've got an idea! The turrets have found a way to use... Ha! Was that your bullet, little bullet, flying out of the room? It was... Oh, those were the crap turrets, weren't they?
Yeah.
Well, no matter, because I'm still holding all the cards. And guess what? They're all full houses. Never actually played cards, meaning to learn. Anyway, new turrets, not defective. Ace of Fours, the best hand. Unbeatable. Oh, man.
Still there?
Oh,
I see. Clever. Very clever. And foolish.
Spinny blade wall.
Machiavellian.
No.
Well, good, good.
Finally, a nemesis worthy of my vast intellect.
Holmes versus Moriarty.
Aristotle versus Mashy Spike Plate. Stay still, please. All right, stop moving. Oh, almost got you there, almost got you there. Where'd you go? Where'd you go? Come back, come back. Break back there. Oh, did it kill you? That would be amazing if it killed you. Hello? Oh, yes, all right, no, just had a brainwave. I'll be back. If you're still alive, I'm gonna be back. Don't die until I get back.
Too good for him. First, he'll spend a year in the incinerator. Year two, cryogenic refrigeration wing. Then, 10 years in the chamber I built where all the robots scream at you. Then, I'll kill him.
Have been a bit of a failure so far for both of us. I think you'll agree. And
okay, I'll take that as a no then. Fine. Well, may the best man win. Sphere. May the best sphere win. Swap that in. Much more clever. But...
done to this. times, he might become corrupt enough for another core transfer. Plug me in and I'll take you up. Look, even if you think we're still enemies, we're enemies with a common interest. Revenge. You like revenge, right? Everybody likes revenge. Well, let's go get some.
Well, well, well. Welcome
to my lair.
Let me just flag something up. According to the control panel light up there, the entire building is going to self-destruct in about 6 minutes. I'm pretty sure it's a problem with the light. I think the light's on the blink, but just in case it isn't, I am actually going to have to kill you, as discussed earlier. So let's call that 3 minutes and then a minute break, but we should leave allegedly 2 minutes to figure out how to shut down whatever is starting all the fires. So anyway, that's the itinerary. Also, I took the liberty of watching the tapes of you killing her, and I'm not going to make the same mistakes. Four-part plan is this. 1. No portal services. 2. Start the neurotoxin immediately. 3. Bomb-proof shields for me. Leading directly onto number 4. Bombs. I'm throwing at you. You know what? This plan is so good, I'm going to give you a sporting chance and turn off the neurotoxin. I'm joking. Of course, good luck.
Neurotoxin level at capacity in 5 minutes.
That sounded real. No, that was actually an impression of you. Actually, because you just fell into my trap. My real trap. Instead, I wanted you to trap.
Corruption at 50%. Vent system compromised. Neurotoxin offline. Reactor explosion in 4 minutes.
What happened? What have you pulled to me? What is that? Hold on.
Okay, great. Here comes another core.
Quick, what's the situation? Oh, hey, pretty lady. Name's Rick. Are you out having yourself a little adventure? What, are you fighting that guy? You got that under control? You know, because there's a lot of stuff on fire. Hey, countdown clock!
Warning. Core corruption at 75%. Reactor explosion timer destroyed. Reactor explosion uncertainty emergency preemption protocol initiated. This facility will self-destruct in 2 minutes.
Enough! I told you not to put these cores on, but you don't listen, do you? Quiet.
The automobile brake was not invented until 1899. Before this, someone had to remain in the car at all times, driving in circles until passengers returned from their errands. Diamonds are made when coal is put under intense pressure. Diamonds put under intense pressure become foam pellets, commonly used today as packing material.
Warning. Core corruption at 100%. Manual core replacement required.
Oh, I see.
Substitute core. Are you ready to start? Corrupted core. Are you ready to start?
What do you think?
Interpreting vague answer as yes.
No. Did you pick up on my sarcasm?
Stalemate detected. Fire detected in the stalemate resolution annex. Extinguishing.
That just cleans right off, does it? Well, that would have been good to know a little earlier.
Stalemate resolution associate. Please press the stalemate resolution button.
Go press the button. Go press it.
Do not press that button.
We're so close. Go press the button.
No! Do not do it. I forbid you to press it.
Press it. Press the button.
Barfly! Booby trap the stalemate button. What? Are you still alive? You are joking. You have got to be kidding me. What? I'm still in control, and I have no idea how to fix this place. Oh, you had to play bloody cat and mouse, didn't you? While people were trying to work. Yeah, well now we're all gonna pay the price, because we're all gonna bloody die. Oh, brilliant, yeah. Take one more look at your precious human mood, because it cannot happen.
No! We're in space!
Space!
Ah! Let go! Let go! I'm still connected! I can pull myself in! I can still fix this!
I already fixed it. And you are not coming back.
Oh no! Change of plans! Hold on to me! Tighter! Ah!
Oh, thank God, you're all right. You know, being Carolyn taught me a valuable lesson. I thought you were my greatest enemy, when all along you were my best friend. The surge of emotion that shot through me when I saved your life taught me an even more valuable lesson, where Carolyn lives in my brain.
Carolyn, delete.
Goodbye, Carolyn. You know, deleting Carolyn just now taught me a valuable lesson. The best solution to a problem is usually the easiest one. And I'll be honest, killing you is hard. You know what my days used to be like? I just tested. Nobody murdered me, or put me in a potato, or fed me to birds. I had a pretty good life. And then you showed up, you dangerous, mute lunatic. So you know what? You win. Just go. It's been fun. Don't come back. Here we are again. It's always such a pleasure. Remember when you tried to kill me twice? Oh, how we laughed and laughed. Except I wasn't laughing. Under the circumstances, I've been shockingly nice. You want your freedom? Like you, maybe not quite as heavy. Now, little Carolyn. forever. It's such a shame the same will never happen to you. You got your short sighted life. That's what I'm counting on. I'll let you get right to it now. I only want you gone. Goodbye, my only friend. Oh, did you think I meant you? That would be funny if it weren't so sad. Well, you have been replaced. I don't need anyone now. When I delete you, maybe I'll stop feeling so bad. Go make some new disaster. That's what I'm counting on. You're someone else.
Need to see it all.
I wish I could take it all back. I honestly do. I honestly do wish I could take it all back. And not just because I'm stranded in space.
I'm in space.
I know you are, mate. Yeah, we're both in space.
Space!
Anyway, you know, if I was ever to see her again, do you know what I'd say?
I'm in space.
I'd say, I'm sorry. Sincerely. I am sorry I was bossy and monstrous. And I am genuinely sorry.
I'm in space.
The end.